Hello, this is Lovely Lovebird Designs, and today in this tutorial we'll be showing you how to make a witch on the rainbow loom. And in the previous tutorial I have a wizard, and this witch has a wand and a broom, and there will be another tutorial for the wand and the broom separate from the witch one. And this one has a staff, which is inside the wizard tutorial. So the witch actually has a pointed nose and a chin and a wart, if you want to add a wart. And this witch, I used rainbow color skin tones and purple and black for the hat and the dress, and gray for the hair. In the tutorial I'm going to use today, I'm going to use a lighter shade of purple with the black, and you can use all black if you'd like also. And I'm going to use olive green bands for the skin. So let's get started. And we first will make the head and the hat on the rainbow loom. Then we're going to take it off and then attach it to a body. So it's going to be two separate pieces and attached on the neck. So let's get started. And it's going to be single loom, straight configuration. So I'm going to use a black and a purple for the first bands. Everything is doubled, so I'm going to use a pattern of black and purple and double black. If you don't want to use a color in your outfit, you can just do a single color also. So I'm going to do black and purple on this middle pin. Then I'm going to do another black and purple on the left. And then a double black in the middle. A double black on the left side. Black and purple. And diagonal of double black. Okay, now I'm going to go three across, and this will be a black and purple. A double black. And a black and purple. Now I'm going to do black and purple black. Okay, black and purple. And purple. Okay, another black. Black and purple. And a black. Now we're coming to the rim, and we're going to go into the color of the skin. I'm using olive green. You can use the skin tone or any kind of color you'd like. I'm going to use double bands. Okay, and we're going to go across. Everything is double of the same color. Another row. Now we're going to make the chin area. And we're going to connect to this pin. Okay, the neck area will be a triple band to make the neck area stronger. So three bands. Now we're going to use the capping band as the color of your dress. I'm going to use a double black band wrapped three times around. Okay, just like that. Now we're going to work on the rim of the hat, and you're going to use your hook. Take one colored band, one purple, one black, wrap it around the hook three times. One, two, three. Take another black and purple and place that on that stitch. I'm going to make one more black and purple stitch. Okay, so it looks like that. Two stitches, and we're going to place that right here. Push all these bands down. Okay, we're going to make another side hat of the hat right here. So another black and purple, three times around. Okay, another black and purple, and place that on that stitch. Okay, another black and purple. And we're going to place it right here. Okay, so now we're going to make the rim of the hat, which I call pom-poms. And we're going to take another black and a purple three times around. And then another black and purple. Place it on here. So you have two sets. Three. Now take a black single. Okay, remember, black single. And place them on them, on the black single. Now place the end of this band right here. Place this on top and place the other end on this pin. And put the two pom-poms in the middle. And then we're going to take another black and purple and wrap three times around each pin. This is going to make the rim of the hat. So I'll show you how to do that. Just take your black and purple, push it down, wrap three times around. Okay, another one right here. Three times around. Okay, and then another one here. Two and three. Okay, so it looks like that. And it's going to make it look all puffy on the rim. Now we can make the eyes. I'm going to use bands for these, just two black bands. And you can use beads if you want to. I wrap it around six times. Okay, that's one eye, and then six times. And that's two. Get your color of the skin that you want and place them on there. And then your eyes will go on this pin. The top goes on top of that pin. And then hook back on the right pin. And the eyes go in the middle. Now we're going to work on the nose. The nose is a longer nose. And I'm going to wrap this five times. For a little pointy nose, then you take one band, twist it onto itself. Place it on the hook and pull the point of your nose on it. Okay, so it looks like that. Now you're going to take another single band, twist it upon itself, and place that on there. Then take one more single band, do not twist it, and place that on there, and you have a nose. And we're going to place that right on this pin. Place the nose on top of this one, just like the eyes, and then secure it here. So it looks like that. Now we're going to make the chin. I'm not making a mouth because my witch doesn't have teeth. So her mouth goes indented. It's a little ugly, but it's ugly cute. Okay, so we're going to do the chin and take a single band, wrap it around five times. Single twist upon itself. And then place that on here. And then back on your hook, take another single band, do not twist it, and then place your chin right on there. Then we're going to place it on this pin, place the chin on top of that pin, and then on the right pin. And that's your chin. Okay, now if you wanted to add a wart, some witches have warts, we're gonna do a single band, wrap five times around, or even six if you like. I'm gonna do six. Okay, now take a single band. So you wrap this around five or six times. Take a single band and place it on the band. Okay, make sure it bunches up a little circle, like a little ball, and that is your wart. You can place the end right here on this pin, and then the connecting pin is right here where the chin is. You can place your chin right through it. Now, in this witch, I didn't have a mouth, but I decided if you want a mouth, I'm going to place one right here. So, and if you don't like how it looks, you can just break the band off at the end anyway. So take one band, wrap it around two times, and just place it right there. And then I'll show you how to make the mouth. Now we're going to make structural bands for the hat. And I'm going to use black, and I'm going to use a single band to make a triangle. Another single triangle, single triangle. Now here I'm going to do a single, but I'm going to twist it so it's two, and then place it on there. So it's a single twist right over here. And then we're going to do another single twist right on these two pins. Okay, so this is how the face and the hat of your witch should look like. Now we're going to start looping. And we're going to dig under and get these three bands and bring them forward. and now we're looking for this band because it's on the top. Double. Bring that forward. Now we're looking for this band. Bring that forward. Now we'll be looking for this band. Now I'm going to loop this side up. Okay, it's thick here, so just place it on top. Now I'm going to loop this side up and we'll leave the middle for last. Push that down. Now I'm going to loop this middle part. And remember, there's this band. We don't want to take that. Just the bottom two bands. Okay, and loop that forward. Now here is your chin. I would put my finger right here. Take the chin out through that band. So there's your chin. Now I'm going to loop forward. Do not take that black band for the mouth. You know, I'm going to place it down and bring that black band over for the mouth. Sorry about that. Okay, so there's your mouth. Then bring it forward and bring your nose through that band right there. So you have a nose, your little mouth, and if you don't like the mouth later, you can always just snap this off, and your chin. Now we're working on in between the eyes, just like that. Now we're going to work with these pom-poms that we've made before. And we're just going to take you had the purple and the black wrapped three times around. We're going to bring it forward onto these olive bands. So you can see the side view. I'm just going to grab those bands. And bring them out like that. Bring them over. So now you just have the olive band and you have your little pom-pom here. We're going to do the same thing for these two. So I'm going to grab those bands. Bring it out. Make sure you have all of them. Just like that. We'll work on this one. Okay, and that's all of them. So I'm going to double check. I'm missing one purple here. Okay, there we go. Now we're going to loop forward and it's going to be a black. Yes, a double black on the bottom. Okay, this one's a purple and a black all the way at the bottom. And this one's a black. the hard part's done. Now we just loop forward. And here's a diagonal, so we're going to bring this on the diagonal to connect it. Now we'll work in the middle. Going to stop on this pin. Okay, so stop right there. Now we're going to work on the left side. And then non-diagonal, and then the final stitch. Okay, now I'm going to take a double band, one purple and one black, and make a slip knot right on the top. And this is what it should look like. So we look at that. And remember, if you don't like the mouth when it comes off, you can always take that off too. So I'm going to slowly take it off the loom. Now stretch out the hat. Okay, stretch out the sides. The pom-poms bring up to make the rim of the hat. Bring up this middle one and this side one. You can bring out the ones in the middle that we made. So it looks like a rim, and you can see the eyes are right in there. The nose you can bring out, you can even bend it a little bit, so it's a little crooked. The chin bring out, and this is the mouth area. If you don't like the mouth, then you can always just snip it off. And here's your wart. If you added a wart, just bring that out. And there is your witch. Now I hide the excess bands in the back. Within the stitch. Okay, just like that. And just bring the rim up, and there's your witch. Okay, now we're going to work on the body, and we're going to attach it, attach the head to the body. Okay, I'm going to be making the arms first, and I'm going to use the colored plus the black and make it a little bigger at the end. So we're going to do a double black. Okay, then a single black and a single purple. Then a double black. And a single purple and a single black. Okay, now to make the extension for the frill of the dress, I'm going to use a double, one single purple and one black. Put it on this pin, so the third pin. One, two, three. Put on a diagonal. Then I'm going to do a black, double black. Right there. Now we're going to take your skin tone. I'm going to use olive, a double for the wrist area, and the capping band will be a single wrapped four times around. And four. And that is your arm. I'm going to make another arm right here. So another double black. Purple and a black. Double black. Purple and a black. Okay, then we're going to do a purple and a black on this pin. So one, two, three. And then another double black here. Okay, double of your skin tone. And one single wrap four times around. Okay, now we can start looping. Okay, we're going to grab this diagonal. And then another diagonal going that way. Now we're going to go straight up. Okay, now we'll work on this. Skin tone, then take your double black and your purple black to the side, and then loom straight up. Okay, this is how your arms are supposed to look like. I have a toothpick to hold them. You can also use another hook or a Q-tip. I'm going to take off the loom. Okay, and that's how your arm should look like. So I'm going to place it on the toothpick. And if not, you can also just place it this on the table too. Hold that for later. Okay, and your second arm. Okay, put that to the side. Now we're going to work on the dress. And we're going to use, put the dress on the loom, then we're going to attach the arms and the head. Okay, first I'm going to take a double black and place it right in the middle. Now I'm going to make the shoulders. So I'm going to use a purple and a black. Okay, from this pin to this, and then we're going to do another one connecting to the left pin of the purple and the black. Okay, now we're going to have a purple and a black going down. We already have the black here, and we're going to do purple and black here. Now we're going to do black, double black. And we're going to do this all the way down to 9 stitches. Same pattern. So now purple and black. And a double black. Now purple black. And a double black. And purple black. Double black, purple black, and a double black. Okay, purple black. Double black and a purple black. Okay, that's double black, purple black, and a double black. Here's purple black, double black, and a purple black. Another double black, purple black. And a double black. Okay, let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Another row. So another purple black, a double black, and a purple black. Okay, let's put the head on this pin. We're just going to put this black part that we have. Place it right on there. Now we're going to place the arms that we made before. Right on that pin. Now another arm right here. Okay, now the capping bands. We're going to make a little frail on the side of each. So I'm going to take a black band, wrap it around 4 times. Then I'm going to take a purple and a black. Place your capping band just like that. Then I'm going to take another black and black. So a double black. And place it just as so. Now take your capping band, place it right here on this pin. So the third pin up. 1, 2, 3. Place your little capping band. Then place this band right here. And that's going to be a little frill on the dress. Okay, we're going to make another one on this side. So take a black band, wrap around 4 times. Then take a purple and a black band. Place that just as so, and then another double black. Okay, just like the other one, place your your capping band. Third pin up. And then put the other band right here. Now, how we did the rim of the hat, we're going to do the same as the bottom. So we're going to take just a single purple and another black, wrap it around 3 times. Okay, take another single black and single purple, wrap around 3 times. Take a single black, place them on there. Okay, separate them, place it right on the bottom, place your band on top of this, and your pom-pom in the middle. Okay, now your capping bands, I'm going to make it more puffy, and do another single purple, single black, wraps 3 times around. That's your capping band. Take another single and wrap 3 times around. And another one right here. Single purple, single black. And 3. Okay, structural bands are pretty easy. They're just triangle, single black, going all the way up. So single, going all the way up. And you can make another triangle up here too. Okay, and this is what your layout should look like. So now we're going to start looping straight up. And I'm going to start on this side, and it will be the lowermost band. It's very thick, but the lowermost is a purple and a black. Broke one of the blacks, so I'm just going to place it, fix that. I'm going to place this one back on here. Place my black on top, go back under. Grab that black band. and pull it forward. Now I have the purple band that I already had out, and I just fixed that problem. And I'm going to loom it straight up. I'm going to stop right here and do this last part last. Okay, now I'm going to loom the middle, and this bottom part is a double black. Just loom straight up. Loop that right to the top, to the neck area. Now we're going to go same as before, we're grabbing this band. It's a single purple, single black. Hopefully this one won't break. Now we're going, this is very thick, these bands, and we're going to grab these bands. I'm going to grab this one first and bring it to the middle pin. It's going to be a black and a purple. Place it just like that. Now I'm going to grab this band. Just like that. Now I'm going to take two slip knots to connect everything together. So I'm going to use a double black. You can use whatever colors you want. It's going to make the neck area of the dress. So a double. And then bring it through and make a slip knot. On the side of the neck. Okay, just like that. Now we're going to take another one and do on that side. It's another double black, whatever colors you choose. And on the other side, make a slip knot. Okay, and this is what it looks like. So we can take it slowly off the loom. It's a lot of bands. left arms are thick. Okay, and we'll get the other arm. Now the thickest part is right here. Okay. Now you have the witch. Which is cool about this, if you want to keep it like this, they can be little frills in the front, like a little scarf. Or you can just take all of them and wrap it two times around the neck. It'll be more like a turtleneck. Just like that, and it holds the head up straight too. So now the bottom, you have these little side extensions, pull them out. You have one couple here too, pull them out. You have those pom-poms that we made before, you can pull them, straighten them out. It's more flowing. And you have a witch. Now if you like her without hair, you can keep her like that. Or else I'm going to show you right now how to make hair for her. I'm going to use black hair because she has a green face. I'm going to show you one strand. You have to make six of them. So it's single band, black. I'm going to use black, or you can use whatever color you want. And we're going to go down 9 times, or you can go down a couple times, however many times, however short or long you want your hair. Mine's going to be a little bit long. So that's 3. Remember, these are single bands. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Capping band 3 times around. And then you loop forward. Make 6 of these to attach to the back of the head. If you want longer hair, you can go all the way to the bottom too. And if you want shorter, you can just go up here too. Okay, please take it off the loom. And this is one strand. I've already made 5 others, so you can pause right now and make your 5, and then I'll show you how to attach it. Okay, so here are your 6 bands, 9 stitches long, and your witch. And I'm going to show you, there's 3 bands total, but there's 6 double banded areas of the olive skin. And basically you just take your strand of hair, place it on your hook, take the outside part off, hold it, then you take your hook, go under your olive skin, place your hairband on there, on the hook, then take your black band over here and bring it under the olive skin, and now it's attached, and you make a slip knot. Just like that. Okay, and we're going to do all 6 bands. So just place it on the hook. Take the outermost off. Go underneath your skin tone band. Place the black back on, bring it under the skin tone. Now you have the 2 bands and make a slip knot. Okay, now we're on to the next. Okay, same procedure. Go under, grab your black band, bring it under, and slip knot. Go under, grab your black band, bring that under, and then slip knot. And we're on the last two. Grab your black band and slip knot. Pretty easy. Okay, grab your black band, pull it under, and a slip knot. Okay, so now you have all these excess bands. What I do is I put the hair up, grab the slip knots that you just made, put it on your finger, and make sure that they're all under the hair. You can put another black through. Put your hook through. Put another black band. And make another slip knot to hold it all together. You can put a hook, clip, or you can tie it. And I just leave it in the back, because it's black and it's part of, you can just add it to the hair. So now you have hair in the back. Bring the eyes out a little bit. See what the hair does? It's a big difference. You can tie it in the back too in a ponytail, which would look cool. And she has a profile, a 3D effect. And she's a really cool looking witch. And I'm also going to have a separate tutorial for the broom and the wand. So please subscribe to Lovely Lovebird Designs. I really hope you like this tutorial, and we'll see you soon. Come back to Lovely Lovebird Designs for the broom tutorial too. Okay, bye-bye. Place this on top and place the other end on this pin. And put the two pom-poms in the middle. And then we're going to take another black and purple and wrap three times around each pin. This is going to make the rim of the hat. So I'll show you how to do that. Just take your black and purple, push it down, wrap three times around. Okay, another one right here. Three times around. Okay, and then another one here. Two and three. Okay, so it looks like that. And it's going to make it look all puffy on the rim. Now we can make the eyes. I'm going to use bands for these, just two black bands. And you can use beads if you want to. I wrap it around six times. Okay, that's one eye, and then six times. And that's two. Get your color of the skin that you want and place them on there. And then your eyes will go on this pin. The top goes on top of that pin. And then hook back on the right pin. And the eyes go in the middle. Now we're going to work on the nose. The nose is a longer nose. And I'm going to wrap this 5 times. For a little pointy nose, then you take one band, twist it onto itself. Place it on the hook and pull the point of your nose on it. Okay, so it looks like that. Now you're going to take another single band, twist it upon itself, and place that on there. Then take one more single band, do not twist it, and place that on there, and you have a nose. And we're going to place that right on this pin. Place the nose on top of this one, just like the eyes, and then secure it here. So it looks like that. Now we're going to make the chin. I'm not making a mouth because my witch doesn't have teeth. So her mouth goes indented. It's a little ugly, but it's ugly cute. Okay, so we're going to do the chin and take a single band, wrap it around 5 times. Single twist upon itself. And then place that on here. And then back on your hook, take another single band, do not twist it, and then place your chin right on there. Then we're going to place it on this pin. Hello, this is Lovely Lovebird Designs, and today in this tutorial we'll be showing you how to make a witch on the rainbow loom. And in the previous tutorial I have a wizard. And this witch has a wand and a broom, and there will be another tutorial for the wand and the broom separate from the witch one. And this one has a staff, which is inside the wizard tutorial. So the witch actually has a pointed nose and a chin and a wart, if you want to add a wart. And this witch, I used rainbow color skin tones and a purple and black for the hat and the dress, and gray for the hair. In the tutorial I'm going to use today, I'm going to use a lighter shade of purple with the black, and you can use all black if you'd like also. And I'm going to use olive green bands for the skin. So let's get started. And we first will make the head and the hat on the rainbow loom. Then we're going to take it off and then attach it to a body. So it's going to be 2 separate pieces and attached on the neck. So let's get started, and it's going to be single loom, straight configuration. So I'm going to use a black and a purple for the first bands. Everything is doubled, so I'm going to use a pattern of black and purple and double black. If you don't want to use a color in your outfit, you can just do a single color also. So I'm going to do black and purple on this middle pin. Then I'm going to do another black and purple on the left. And then a double black in the middle. A double black on the left side, black and purple, and diagonal of double black. Okay, now I'm going to go 3 across, and this will be a black and purple, double black. And a black and purple. And now I'm going to do black. Black and purple. Black. Okay, black and purple. Black. Black and purple. Okay, another black. Black and purple. And a black. Okay, now we're coming to the rim and place the chin on top of that pin and then on the right pin. And that's your chin. Okay, now if you wanted to add a wart, because some witches have warts, we're gonna do a single band, wrap five times around, or even six if you like. We're gonna do six. Okay, now take a single band. So you wrap this around five or six times. Take a single band and place it on the band. Okay, make sure it bunches up a little circle, like a little ball, and that is your wart. You can place the end right here on this pin, and then the connecting pin is right here where the chin is. You can place your chin right through it. Now, in this witch, I didn't have a mouth, but I decided if you want a mouth, I'm going to place one right here. So, and if you don't like how it looks, you can just break the band off at the end anyway. So take one band, wrap it around two times, and just place it right there. And then I'll show you how to make the mouth. Now we're going to make structural bands for the hat. And I'm going to use black, and I'm going to use a single band to make a triangle. Another single triangle, single triangle. Now here I'm going to do a single, but I'm going to twist it so it's two, and then place it on there. So it's a single twist right over here. And then we're going to do another single twist right on these two pins. Okay, so this is how the face and the hat of your witch should look like. Now we're going to start looping. And we're going to dig under and get these three bands and bring them forward. Okay, now we're looking for this band because it's on the top. Double. Bring that forward. Now we're looking for this band. Bring that forward. Now we'll be looking for this band. Now I'm going to loop this side up. it's thick here, so just place it on top. Now I'm going to loop this side up and we'll leave the middle for last. Okay, push that down. Now I'm going to loop this middle part. And remember, there's this band. We don't want to take that, just the bottom two bands. We're going to go into the color of the skin. I'm using olive green. You can use the skin tone or any kind of color you'd like. I'm going to use double bands. Okay, and we're going to go across. Everything is double of the same color. Okay, another row. Now we're going to make the chin area, and we're going to connect to this pin. Okay, the neck area will be a triple band to make the neck area stronger. So three bands. Now we're going to use the capping band as the color of your dress. I'm going to use a double black band wrapped three times around. Okay, just like that. Now we're going to work on the rim of the hat. And you're going to use your hook. Take one colored band, one purple, one black. Wrap it around the hook three times. One, two, three. Take another black and purple and place that on that stitch. I'm going to make one more black and purple stitch. Okay, so it looks like that. Two stitches. I'm going to place that right here. Push all these bands down. Okay, we're going to make another side hat of the hat right here. So another black and purple three times around. Okay, another black and purple and place that on that stitch. Okay, another black and purple. And we're going to place it right here. Okay, so now we're going to make the rim of the hat, which I call pom-poms. And we're going to take another black and a purple three times around. And then another black and purple. Place it on here. So you have two sets. Three. Now take a black single. Okay, remember, black single. And place them, on the black single. Now place the end of this band right here. Okay, and loop that forward. Now here is your chin. I would put my finger right here. Take the chin out through that band. Okay, so there's your chin. Now I'm going to loop forward. Do not take that black band for the mouth. You know, I'm going to place it down and bring that black band over for the mouth. Sorry about that. Okay, so there's your mouth. Then bring it forward and bring your nose through that band right there. So you have a nose, your little mouth, and if you don't like the mouth later, you can always just snap this off, and your chin. Now we're working on in between the eyes, just like that. Now we're going to work with these pom-poms that we've made before, and we're just going to take the purple and the black wrapped three times around. We're going to bring it forward onto these olive bands. So you can see the side view. Just going to grab those bands. And bring them out like that. Bring them over. So now you just have the olive band and you have your little pom-pom here. We're going to do the same thing for these two. So I'm going to grab those bands. Bring it out. Make sure you have all of them. Just like that. We'll work on this one. Okay, and that's all of them. So I'm going to double check. Missing one purple here. Okay, there we go. Now we're going to loop forward and it's going to be a black. Yes, a double black on the bottom. Okay, this one's a purple and a black. All the way at the bottom. And this one's a black. Okay, the hard part's done. Now we just loop forward. And here's a diagonal, so we're going to bring this on the diagonal to connect it. Now we'll work in the middle. Okay, we're all the way up. Okay, we're going to stop on this pin.